Hey guys, welcome back to the Fandom Minutes. I'm Mike.
And I'm Matt.
And as you can see, I'm back.
Finally, it took you long enough. Did you get it?
I got it.
What is it, Foley?
We have a problem. One of ours is unaccounted for on the surface.
Elf? Dwarf? Goblin?
Hard to tell, but it's big. Could be a deep tunnel breakout. Perhaps through a vault or dormant volcano.
Send someone up to identify it.
All active duty officers are downtown, searching for the Aculos.
So, for today's episode, I had the idea of doing 20 Mandela Effect.
Really?
Yes. So, if you don't know what the Mandela Effect is, you really need to research it. It's pretty crazy. So, people around the world are having different memories of past events. So they'll say, you know, something is this way, and then when they go and look, and it's completely wrong.
So the official description is the Mandela Effect refers to a situation in which a large mass of people believes that an event occurred when it did not. Looking at the origin of the Mandela Effect, some famous examples, as well as some potential explanations for this strange confluence of perceptions, can be held to shed light on this unique phenomenon. And that's what we're going to do today.
So I thought, since it's 2020, we would discuss 20 Mandela effects.
Seems fair.
So I tried to find ones that were rarer, because there's tons of ones that you hear over and over and over again. And I've got a few of those on there, on the list, because I thought they were good ones. And I thought maybe you hadn't heard of them. But, so I got a couple that are maybe repeats for you guys. But I'm trying to mainly stick to new stuff. So, but I thought we'd start out, because you and me have already talked about this, and it kind of blew my mind. C-3PO. Was he all gold? Like, top to bottom, gold. Or did he have a silver leg?
He did, in fact, have a silver leg. Now, a lot of people have debated this one.
I remember him as being all gold, no silver leg at all, like throughout the whole movie, gold.
I personally had never thought about it, up until a point where I actually saw and recognized that he had a silver leg. And it definitely caught me off guard. And I brought it to my dad's attention.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, he was a huge Star Wars fan, and yeah. He knew. He said, yeah, it was a silver leg. And that the background of where they were at, you know, the desert, the reflection from the leg and the sand caused it to also look gold. This was expanded on further when I actually watched a YouTube video with the actor who portrays C-3PO.
Nice.
And he explained that toys were produced, which you said you've got one.
I have one of the really, really old toys that's C-3PO, and it's all gold.
The reason the toys were produced solid gold is for the same reason. When they took the camera shoots, they did it in a studio setting, but the reflection from the flash of the camera caused that leg to look gold. You know, they didn't have people go, yeah, that looks good, let's do that. You know, they made the toys, packaged them, sold them. And so toys were actually made with solid gold leg and everything.
But see, that doesn't completely make sense to me. I mean, like, I get it that, I mean, it's possible, but being a photographer, whenever I take a picture of something, I mean, this is back in the 80s, obviously, but even back then, I mean, they had pretty good cameras, you know, for what they had. I've seen, you know, pictures from the 80s and even earlier, you could tell what was what. And so what gets me is even a flash, whatever it bounces off of, I feel like the silver on his leg was so contrasted to the yellow. It was really close, because the goldish, yellowish color was really light, just like the silver. But I feel like even with the flash back, you know, coming back to the camera, which is what they said made it look gold, it's hard to say. I mean, the only thing I could think of is if somehow the Flash hit most of the gold, bounced off the floor, and then came back and made the lake look gold. That's the only way that I could think of is that working is by the Flash hitting his mainly gold torso, the light hits the floor and bounces back, causing the leg to also look gold. That's the only thing I can think of. Otherwise, the silver should have flashed back as silver and not gold.
So you are correct in that things were a lot different with the way things were, pictures were taken mm-hmm. and things. But let's check out this quick little clip here from the actor himself.
Okay.
One thing I want to remind you of, back in the day in episode 4, 3PO didn't have two gold legs. He had one silver shin. A lot of people didn't notice it. And the reason is it was kind of subtle, and the silver actually reflected the gold of the other leg. And also in the desert, it reflected the gold of the sand. To such an extent that John Jay, the beloved stills photographer, and he'd been shooting stills all through the shoot, on the last day in the desert, he came up to me and said, Townes, why are you wearing a silver leg today? And I thought, oh, a blind cameraman, who knew?
And so he just explained from his point of view, as the actor, what the experience was.
That was very interesting.
For me, that was kind of a nail in the coffin.
Right. Thing.
Like, he was C-3PO himself.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. So he should remember, if anybody.
I took his word for it. Okay. So,
but what if he's one of the ones that... So, a thing with the Mandela effect that I don't think we've touched on yet is not everyone remembers the same right. things. So, maybe he's one of the ones... So, it kind of delves into this whole alternate universe, this multiverse, like they have in Marvel, if you guys are familiar with that. So, we're going down the timeline, right? Well, time is actually all wibbly-wobbly, as Doctor Who says. Time isn't a straight line, because, as Albert Einstein says, time is relative. So if you're going fast, time moves slower. So it changes depending on what's happening around the person. And so if you ever stared at a wall or stared at a microwave and a minute felt like forever, but when you're going through the day, does that minute still feel like forever?
No.
So what's interesting is there is this giant, what's the name of it?
Hydrogen collider?
Yeah, that's it.
Hydron collider?
Hydron collider. So there's this giant hydron collider that collides tiny particles at super fast speeds. And they've already used it to find what they call the God particle. And this God particle is what they believe was like the first particle that made up absolutely everything. And they called it that because they thought, well, if we can find this, we can explain everything. And so they did find it, but they've only been able to produce it, I think, like once. But the thing is this shoots these protons out, which those are super tiny. But when they collide, stuff happens. Energy is released, lots of energy. And so the theory goes that I've watched, I'll try to put the link in the description below. These guys talk about, and they really go into depth and talk to scientists, and so there's a theory that it's messing with time. So every time they collide, it messes with time. So how the theory goes is that I'm here and you're here, right? Well, I might have a different memory of the same event than you do because I was in the timeline that had it and you were in the timeline that didn't. And so we're constantly in flux, so we don't notice that we're moving in and out of dimensions. It's just simultaneously. It's so close that only a few things are changing here and there for each person. Which is it? Smokey the Bear? Or Smokey Bear?
Smokey Bear.
I could have swore it was Smokey the Bear. No. Dude, Smokey the Bear. Who doesn't say Smokey the Bear? How is it Smokey Bear? That just sounds bad.
Because I've always seen him as Smokey's his first name and Bear's his last name. Smokey Bear.
That makes sense. But, like, that just sounds...
They wouldn't call you Matt the Human.
No, but this is like a cartoon thing. Like, this is like, I don't know, Smokey the Bear just sounds frightening.
But I do know a lot of people who do say Smokey the Bear.
Yeah. Which is weird, right? If it's always 100% been Smokey Bear.
Like, for me, I always glanced it off as one of those, like, as a kid, even now, I'm still a huge wrestling fan. And I had people that would talk about Hulk Hogan as Hawk Hogan. So I just took it as one of those situations where somebody
tomato,
just,
tomato kind of thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, just throwing an extra word. It's possible. It's very possible. Do you remember Henry VIII? Do you remember a painting, like maybe in history class or something? Do you remember this famous Henry VIII? Like, he had a chicken wing. Like, he had this whole... He was super dressed nice, and he had a chicken wing in his hand, right? Well, now... There's no chicken wing there anymore. Because wasn't all the students making fun of this chicken wing he was holding? Because he was fat. He was a plump guy. And I remember this.
He's even. A plump unit.
He was a plump unit. And I recall him, you know, just holding a chicken wing. It wasn't eaten or anything. It was just, or maybe he had like a bite out of it, but it was an oil painting from back in the day. And he just was holding a chicken wing. Just, you know, to show his status. And I think that's what they said at school, was to show his status of richness is the fact that he could afford and have, you know, extravagant meals and could afford this chicken wing. And now, there's never been a painting of him with a chicken wing. See, like, that's what I remember. Except I don't remember it facing him. So this picture we got here, it's facing him. I remember it facing outwards, like this.
Mm-hmm.
Is that what you remember?
I do indeed.
And like, it just kind of like...
Very, very much like a, almost like a playing card image.
Yeah.
Just kind of like.
Yeah, he just was holding the chicken, like, as look at me, I'm fat and rich. So what do you think about that? There was never a chicken wing.
So that one's a tricky one. I know that cartoons used to play that off a lot.
And maybe that's what it was.
So I wonder if maybe it was something like that. Maybe we were seeing
both images, and so we fused them together in our heads.
Right.
So maybe Looney Tunes or something like that had it.
It's very possible.
That's a good one. You remember the movie The Gremlins, right?
Yes.
I mean, who could forget the Mogwai? Don't get them wet. Well, they got wet and they multiplied. And then they ate after midnight, and they became evil, right? So remember that main evil gremlin? Didn't he have a mohawk? I think.
Yes.
It was a white one, right? Like, maybe even had... Stripe. Stripe, right? So, what was his name?
His name was Stripe.
So, it's not Spike?
Pretty sure it was Stripe.
Okay, it is Stripe.
Yeah.
But a lot of people remember...
See, that right there, what just happened there, I knew the answer to that.
Yeah.
But... After you said, are you sure it's not this?
Yeah.
There was enough doubt there that I was almost like, oh, well, maybe it is. And so I've always wondered if maybe that plays
an effect into it. Yeah.
Yeah. Plays a part in it. Like.
But like, you know, this one, I don't know enough about
that,
it.
What's that they say? If it looks like a duck and it quacks like a duck.
Must be a duck.
Must be a duck kind of thing.
Yeah. Okay. Remember that good old show, Sex and the City?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, it's not Sex in the City. Which would make sense. It's actually Sex and the City.
Correct. So, that's another one that I was 100% sure was in the city.
Because there's a bunch of girls having sex in the city.
It just makes sense to be in.
Yeah.
But when I started working at the casino that I worked at, they actually had a game in there, and it was Sex and the City.
Yeah.
And I remember laughing at it because they
misspelled it, right?
The franchise or whatever this is, you know? And then it was brought to my attention that no, it was never in the city. It just made more sense to most people that way.
Well,
it was actually and the city.
There's the theory, though, that even that gaming machine was at one time Sex in the City. But because of the changing in Whipples and time, everything, like whatever it was, that's all changed. It just auto changes. Like, as soon as that name changes or that event changes, everything that is related to that event automatically updates. So the next one is, I know you probably haven't watched many shows where people get Grammys and stuff and whatnot, but there was this famous one that, like, just everyone knows. And remember that girl that gets up there and goes, she's, like, thanking everyone, she's got the thing, she's like, you love me, you really love me. You remember that, right?
So, I remember that phrase, but I don't remember it from some woman, I remember it from The Mask.
Thank you. You love me. You really love me.
That wasn't The Mask.
When he's acting like he got shot and everything.
Yeah.
And he's acting like he died. And they give him the flowers and everything. I remember that. That's what I remember.
Yeah.
So, I don't remember any woman.
You're right. Maybe. So, there was a woman. And a lot of people, maybe that's what they're doing. Maybe they're confusing it with The Mask. But there was a woman that was an actress. And she won an award. And everybody, a lot of people claim that, yeah, that's what she said. And, like, The Mask was just copying what she said. Obviously, that would make sense, right? Why would he copy something that she didn't say? That would be like him just making it up. So it makes more sense that he was copying her. Well, what she actually said doesn't even sound like normal speech. Okay? Listen to this. What she said was, I can't deny the fact that you like me. Right now, you like me. What?
The first time I didn't feel it, but this time I feel it, and I can't deny the fact that you like me. Right now, you like me.
Yeah, so you love me. You really love me. That makes sense, but I can't deny the fact that you like me. Right now, you like me.
So, it's similar, but it's still not what I would have expected. Another situation that's similar to that,
mm-hmm.
Where, you know, one thing is heard by a lot of people, but mm-hmm. it turns out to be something different.
Yeah.
Was Star Wars again.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
With the...
the Luke.
The yep. Luke, I am your father.
See, that's what
I know. I am your father.
Yeah.
That.
So I remember it as Luke, I am your father. Join me and together we can rule the universe as father and son.
So growing up, I was really confused because I remember both situations.
So you were kind of in the middle of the whole dimension thing.
So I remember, no, I am your father.
Obi-Wan never told you what happened to your father.
He told me enough. He told me you killed him.
No, I am your father.
But then I also remember Luke, I am your father. And the reason that I remember that one specifically
uh-huh.
is because another movie that had Chris Farley on it.
Yeah.
He's talking into a fan and it's kind of, you know, when you talk yeah. to a fan, it kind of gives you that choppy
yeah.
robotic kind of voice. And he's doing that and he's saying, Luke, I am your father.
La 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 la, Luke, I am your father.
And so I remember both of them. So, and so when I hear this, I'm like,
So that's interesting. So it could be thrown out that a lot of people saw the Chris Farley film, remembered it, and then put it onto the Star Wars one. Well, I haven't even seen that one movie.
That's the thing real quick.
Yeah.
It's like any other topic out there. A lot of different scenarios that could play out. You're going to have people that go headfirst into it and believe that it's something, you know, just out of this world, into the next. Then you got some people that try to be as grounded as possible. Yeah. And they're like, oh, no, it's just this.
Right.
And then you have people in between that's like, I don't know.
Right.
And so it's that's fun kind to of speculate. Me at the moment. It's yeah. fun to debate on these. And it's fun to sit and just kind of like give out scenarios like, it could have been this, but it could have been that.
Yeah. The next one. You guys remember I Love Lucy, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Remember her, like, husband that had like broken English, right? You remember him rushing in the door, going, "Lucy, you got some explaining to do."
So I do remember that. This is one that I have seen before.
Yeah.
I remember that. I specifically remember that.
Yeah.
I was not a fan of the show by any means, but I remember watching. I believe it was Nick at Night.
Yeah.
Late at night. Yeah. That's how I saw Prince of Bel-Air and stuff like that. And experiencing what I believe was that. Like, I specifically remember that line. Yeah.
Because that's all I remember really from the show is that one line.
But I believe it's not. It's something else, correct?
Yes. So, and it doesn't even make sense this way. He would go open and go, "Explain that if you can."
That just doesn't make sense.
Or explain. Simply, he would be like, "Explain."
Hmm.
Lucy, you got some explaining to do. Lucy, you got some explaining to do.
Oh my!
Lucy, you got some explaining to do. Lucy, you got some explaining to do.
Black dress.
Lucy, you got some explaining to do.
Yeah, that's confusing. Like, yeah. I don't recall that one at all.
Okay, you guys remember Fruit of the Loom, right? Still a brand that's around.
The shirts and underwear?
Yeah. Fruit of the Loom. You remember it having a basket behind the fruit? Kind of like something you'd see at Thanksgiving, right?
Like a cornucopia.
Yeah, cornucopia.
I remember the cornucopia.
Yeah, it had that, right? Not anymore.
Even to this day, like...
Yeah.
When I imagine the Fruit of the Loom logo,
yep.
I imagine the grapes, and I imagine the you know, just the different little fruits and stuff like that they got on
there. Yeah, they definitely have grapes.
I seem to remember the cornucopia coming out the back, you know?
Yeah.
Like, I remember that.
Yeah, and it was never there.
And that's what I've heard. I've heard that, but, like, even to this day, I always forget to look when I'm actually wearing those clothing, or if I... you know, just pick those up somewhere, or if I'm walking to the store, I always forget to look.
Right. So I actually work there, and I've seen them, and it's not there. And you could say it's updated, right? And that's kind of what I thought. I thought, oh, they've updated, and they've taken the cornucopia out, you know, kind of just updated their logo. Well, according to history, now, it's never been there, ever. So you remember Gandalf in Lord of the Rings, right? So this is number, what are we at? Okay, so this is number 9. You remember Gandalf, right?
Mm-hmm.
Remember when he takes on, what was it, the dragon or something? Or the troll? Anyways, he's on the bridge, and he's falling in, right? And he's trying to take whatever, what was it? Do you remember?
It's been so long. It's been
years. Anyways, so Gandalf has taken up this big monster, right? And as he's falling, what does he yell?
Are you talking about the line, "Run, you fools"?
Yeah. It's Run, You Fools, right?
That's what I remember.
That's what I remember.
Fly, you fools!
Okay, you remember Hannibal Lecter and Silence of the Lambs? You remember the famous line, "Hello, Clarice."
So I do, and again, this is another one that was muddled by another movie. Huh? Dr. Doolittle, there's a pig.
Mm-hmm.
I believe it's a pig that says, "Hello, Clarice," to someone.
Strike!
Getting wilder.
Hello, Clarice.
Animals can't organize.
But again,
in those movies, he does not actually say,
"No,
hello, Clarice."
He just says, "Good morning."
Yes.
Good morning.
Dr. Lecter, my name is Clarice Starling. May I speak with you?
Is it possible, again, like you said, that people were just watching that scene in Doolittle and mixed it up with the original?
Or, it's possible.
But then again, why would the pig say it if that's not what he said? So if people weren't already thinking that's what he said before the pig.
In movies like that, typically lines are changed so that the reference is easier to get. If he had just said...
hello.
If he just said hello
or good morning,
you may not have gotten it. But when he throws in the name Clarice, then you kind of know.
That makes sense.
Same with the Luke Skywalker one where he says, If he had been like, no, I am your father, into the fan.
Oh, you're right. Yeah, you know, yeah.
Wouldn't have got it. But if he says, Luke, I am your father, you're like, ah, Star Wars reference.
Ah, I got
so
you.
So I feel like
you.
It's something like that.
That
but
makes sense.
At the same time, again, there's so many of these. And it's crazy to think of, this is all the human mind, you know?
Yeah.
If you want to put it that way, it's the human mind and how quickly and easily it can be confused by things.
This is just all humans' minds messing up. It's weird that all of us, not all of us, but you know,
a large
thousands
yeah.
of people are doing this.
Well, for instance, the original Mandela Effect, which is what it's named for, so that term began when it was first coined in 2009 by Fiona Broom, when she published a website detailing her observance of the phenomenon. She was at a conference talking with other people about how she remembered a tragedy of former South African President Nelson Mandela's death in South African prison in the 1980s. However, he did not die in the 1980s in a prison. He passed away in 2013. As she began to talk to other people about her memories, she learned that she was not alone. Others remembered seeing news coverages of his death, as well as a speech by his widow. She was shocked that such a large mass of people could remember the same identical event in such detail when it never even happened. Encouraged
See,
by her
weird.
Book publisher, she began a website to discuss what she called the Mandela Effect and other incidences like it.
How many states do we have in the U.S.?
We have 50.
Not anymore? Or less? Do we have more or less?
No, we have 50.
50 exactly?
50.
Okay, so I remember... Now, this is something I remember pretty vivid too, right? So I remember we having 50 states, and then for some reason, this is... Okay, this is my memory. It didn't go into this, but this was my memory. I remember we had 50 states, and then I think they added, like, Hawaii or something, and that was the 51st state. And then they added... like Cuba as an extra one, you know, and it was a territory of ours.
Territory.
But some people were considering it a state. So I remember learning in school that they were like, well, we've got 51 states, but we kind of almost have 52 if you kind of want to count that territory as a state.
So,
but there's only been 50 ever.
I remember there being 50. Again, though, when you said that, like after I answered 50, I stopped for a second and thought to myself again, wait a second. And I kind of glanced over the map in my head to make sure.
Yeah.
So again, another one of those situations where...
it's manipulated.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I always remember that there's 48 states. What do they call that?
The Central Isle.
Yeah, when they're all connected there. And then the two off, you know,
Alaska
off to the side.
And Hawaii.
Yes.
Okay, chartreuse. What do you think of? What color do you think of when you think of chartreuse?
So when to be completely honest, when I hear chartreuse, I always think of Sharkleberry Kool-Aid. Why? I don't know. I guess because there's a sh in it. I don't know. But I could not tell you to this day what color chartreuse is.
Okay.
I want to say like a purple or something.
Okay, so a lot of people remember it as almost like a magenta, like a pink color, like a lighter kind of mid-tone pink, almost like what's in the hearts over there on Pikachu. It was called chartreuse. And I remember it as being pink. And I have like an art degree, and I swore telling people, they're like, well, do you have any chartreuse, you know, fabric? Or do you have any chartreuse this? And I'm like, yeah, there's some pink fabric over here. Chartreuse is green. Green. It's... what?
It's interesting,
it's
though.
It's a shade of
so,
green. Which makes sense when you talked about...
when I think of chartreuse, for whatever reason, I think of Sharkleberry Kool-Aid.
Yeah.
Which is actually kind of a pinkish color.
Is it?
Yes, it is. Which is weird, because I don't associate it with a color. I associate it with Kool-Aid.
Yeah, that's great.
But it's the same color as what other people think that it is.
Okay, do you remember The Matrix?
I do.
Remember the phrase that was in every meme ever? What if I told you? Blah, blah, blah.
I do, actually. I remember that as the meme.
Yeah.
And
so it was actually never in the movie.
It was not.
I remember it being in the movie right before he gave out the two choices. I remember him going, "What if I told you everything you believe was a lie?" You know, and then goes into it and he goes, "You have a choice. You can either stay in this world or you can choose to, you know, awaken," or whatever his spiel was after that. That's how I remember him starting the sentences. "What if I told you everything you know is like a lie or isn't real," or something like that.
So, if I remember correctly, isn't it something along the lines of he just says, he doesn't say, "What if I told you?" Yeah. It's just, "What you know is a lie."
Yeah.
"Do you want to know what it is? The Matrix is everywhere. It is all around us. It is the world that has been pulled over your eyes to blind you from the truth."
"What truth?"
"That you are a slave, Neo. Like everyone else, you were born into bondage. Born into a prison that you cannot smell or taste or touch. This is your last chance. After this, there is no turning back. You take the blue pill, the story ends. You wake up in your bed and believe whatever you want to believe. You take the red pill, you stay in Wonderland. And I show you how deep the rabbit hole goes."
And again, I think that, because I do remember this situation, but I have detached, I guess you could say, the meme from the movie. So when I see that meme, I don't even think about the Matrix. I just think of
the funny meme,
the meme itself, and what the meme stands for.
You remember the Thinker, like the big statue?
Mm-hmm.
What's his pose?
So it's always imagined where he's sitting on the toilet looking thing, like he's on a rock, and he's just like, like, that's what I imagine. That's what I always think of.
So you're thinking like this?
Like, he's just like,
See, that's what I thought.
And it's always something like SpongeBob, where he's like, shows him sitting on a toilet or...
Yeah, something funny, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so this one gets weird. I found a website. So this one, don't look up anything yet. So just hear me out first. He's going to his little tablet here. Just hold up. Stop it! I'm gonna smack him. So, the Thinker... You want me to show you what it is right now?
Go ahead.
Before I go. The Thinker right now is this. Like... fist to chin. But I remember it, and a lot of people remember it, as this. Kind of Tim Tebowing. Well, another person made a whole YouTube video, right? When it changed for him. It didn't change, though, to this. It changed to this. When he saw it. So he saw it, he went, and he made a whole video about it, because he thought, he remembered it as this, right? Where you're thinking. And I always remembered as,
I was thinking of this.
Yeah, he's holding his chin, right?
Mm-hmm.
No, it's just a fist. But, so, this guy made a whole YouTube video about it, because he remembers it being on the forehead, right?
Mm-hmm.
So he made a YouTube video about how it's changed to this, with the fingers pointing at the throat.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, "Dude, I swear, it used to be like this." Not talking about the Mandela Effect or anything. He just saw it. He might have talked about the Mandela Effect. But anyways, what I'm saying is he literally saw it like this, went out, made a YouTube video, and it was never like this. It is now changed to this.
So, what it looks like to me on here...
There's one in Kansas City, and I've seen it.
It looks like he's doing this,
mm-hmm.
but he's doing this.
Yeah.
And so, from the angle that you're at... Mm-hmm. I'm thinking, because a lot of times, 90% of the time when you see that picture, he's either pointing face forward at you or kind of just off to the side a little bit. But all these pictures I'm looking at now, he's literally on his side, and he's doing this on all of these pictures.
Doing this?
No, he's doing this.
Okay, bring it up. Let me see. Okay, it's changed again. Dude, it's changed again. Nike. I literally just looked this up. Do I still have the link? Please tell me I still have the link. Yes.
See, he's doing.
It's changed. What? Okay, so this was the guy. It was Shane Robinson made a video about the new pose and posted it to his YouTube channel, Unbiased and On the Fence, March 2017. In it, he speaks clearly. He's clearly shaken by the experience, but what makes it an interesting watch is that he demonstrates the thinker's pose by placing his chin on the back of his hand and fingers against it, his throat. Dude, when I looked earlier, I swear it was like this.
Yeah, everything I'm seeing, every picture I'm looking at, his hand is like this, like against his throat.
Yeah. So, like, here's an example of the lady mocking it, right? But why would she mock it if she literally could, and it looks like a foreigner, why would she mock it if it's right there and mock it wrong? So, that was weird because I swear when I was at work looking this up, maybe I'm wrong. I could have been mistaken, but I swear it had gone to the fist because I was laughing. I was like, who thinks it looks like that? Right? And now that's what it is.
Send us a picture to our Facebook page. We'll post one there.
Yeah, post it. And we'll share it in the next week's episode. Well, if you do the pose that you remember the thinker as, we'll put you in the next week's episode. So the Statue of Liberty, what island is that on?
So the Statue of Liberty, when I think of that,
yep.
I specifically remember Ellis Island. That's what pops in my head.
Ellis Island.
Literally, almost instantly.
Yeah. Now, it would make sense for it to be on Ellis Island, too.
My remembrance of that is never from school. It's never from a history book.
Right.
It's always from an X-Men movie. Specifically, the first one, where they go to rescue Rogue, and they mention going to Ellis Island. They then end up inside of the Statue of Liberty. Well, if you read the plot synopsis, it explains that they end up on Liberty Island.
Which is where it's located. It's on Liberty Island.
But in the movie, Cyclops actually mentions Ellis Island and how people are meeting there and they're going to be attacked and they gotta go save them. And so that's what I remember.
What if things are like, so things are getting rewritten. And some people are even saying that we're virtual reality. And some scientists are really kind of pushing that to look into it. So, and scientists, if you don't know, just discovered a parallel universe where time goes backwards. Mathematically. They said all this all lines up mathematically. So there has to be a universe where time moves backwards. So that was just released last week or the week before. So they just literally found that. So we're finding more and more out that's really weird. So things are getting like rewritten, right? So like you said, he says it. So like it's like part of it was rewritten. They missed changing that and then kept rewriting. So like fragments are still not only in our memories, but in certain areas. Like I found someone with the Berenstein. It's not Berenstein Bears, it's the Berenstain Bears.
Yep.
And there was a person that dug through all the old toys, like way back when, and they held up a book. One said a new one that said Berenstain Bears,
and
the
other one said
Berenstein Bears.
I used to read Berenstain Bears all the time. And even I remember it as Berenstein.
Yeah.
Like I don't remember ever saying Berenstain.
Yeah, this is
now that could be the fact that when you think of that word, you don't think of Stain. You don't see that name very often, Stain. You see Stein or Stain even. You know, you don't see Stain as a name very often. So for me it was something like that.
Okay, where is your heart located at?
Right here.
Is it on the right side or the left side or the center?
So it's when we think of our heart, we always think over here because they tell you to put your hand over your heart.
Yeah, so it's on the left
side. I want to say it's actually more in the center. Like it's not quite.
So it's still up in this area?
Yeah.
But it's literally in the middle.
Yeah, it's not chest. It's not on the, like it's not just like up here like we think.
Yeah.
But because they tell us, put your hand over your heart, Well, I mean, your hand, you don't go like this, you know.
But why wouldn't you? If your hand is, I mean, if your heart's here, why wouldn't you put your hand here? Why
so
would you change?
There was actually a thing I had seen one time about it.
And I guess that's not the only thing that's been changing about the body. So I didn't go into it. I thought the heart was the most interesting because I remember it being on the left, probably for that same reason. But people are finding, when they look into it now, I didn't see anything different necessarily. But, well, except for the small intestines. So the skull apparently has a lot more holes in it. Like, actually, in the skull, it has tons of holes that I don't remember being there. Yeah. And then if you look at the small intestines, the new diagrams, or the diagrams, it looks like someone just wadded up your small intestines and threw it in. Remember that great old song about being Barbie? Right?
Barbie girl?
Yeah, how's it go?
Jacob knows all about that song, don't you, Jake?
How's it go? Both of you. Okay, Mike, go first. How's it go? Wrapped in plastic.
Life is plastic.
Yeah.
It's fantastic.
Yeah.
Hey, Barbie, you wanna go party?
Yeah.
You can brush my hair and dress me anywhere.
Yeah. Yeah. So, it's not I'm a Barbie girl in a Barbie world. It is I'm a Barbie girl in the Barbie world.
Hiya, Bobby.
Hi, Ken.
You wanna go for a ride?
Sure, Ken.
Jump in.
I'm a Barbie girl in the Barbie world. Life in plastic, it's fantastic.
So try singing that and see if it sounds like out loud.
So I can see that now, like hearing it, like thinking about it in my head. It makes sense. It does.
I'm a Barbie girl in the Barbie world, wrapped in plastic. It's fantastic. Or is it wrapped in plastic? Or
I always thought it was life is plastic or life's in plastic.
Yeah, yeah. Now, see, I remember it was wrapped in plastic for some reason, but that doesn't make sense.
But, I mean, this way it makes sense. It still does.
Yeah.
And that could just be coming down to what we hear, like an audio cue we hear. Do you remember the mirror, mirror on the wall?
I know this one thing. Yeah.
You know what it really is?
So I thought, like a lot of people, mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the fairest of them all? It's actually, if I'm not wrong, magic mirror on the wall.
It is.
Who's the fairest of them all?
It is indeed.
Which it rhymes better.
Slave in the magic mirror, come from the farthest space. Through wind and darkness I summon thee. Speak. Let me see thy face.
Thou know, my queen.
Magic mirror on the wall. Who is the fairest one of all?
How about Shazam? One of the most well-known examples.
Now, I kind of remember Shazam.
I 100% remember Shazam, and I will argue to the death that I remember
I know
Shazam.
Shaq did a movie.
One of the most well-known examples of the Mandela Effect is the collective memory of a movie called Shazam that starred the actor-comedian Sinbad in the 1990s. I remember this. I know that I've seen it. In fact, no such movie exists, and it kills me to even say that. Although there was a children's movie called Kazam.
Kazam, that's the one with Shaq.
And some other coincidences that could help to explain how this movie became created in many people's minds. There was something to do with a skit that Sinbad had actually done.
What is that?
good to get out that thing. Woo! Kind of cramped up in there. Should've took you long enough, Tina. Wait, y'all are not Tina.
Kidnapper!
Wait. Where you going? I just got here. What happened to saying hello? I believe we got off on the wrong foot.
Don't come any closer.
Okay, this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna start all over, right? I'm gonna introduce myself. I am Shazam! I'm the genie of the lamp.
All right. So, yeah, that's college humor. Sinbad's.
So it's fake,
Shazam.
Right?
Hmm?
That was fake, right?
That was the skit I was telling you about that he had made.
Oh, okay.
Because. So this was made after.
The Mandela Effect was a thing.
Yeah.
All right, so now that we've gone down the rabbit hole a little bit, so it seems like the Thinker has got us the most kind of baffled out of all those.
Fun fact, the Thinker is also a Flash villain. Just throwing that out there.
So it's really interesting that just this whole memory thing is going on, and I didn't hear about it until 2018, I think.
Really?
Yeah. I didn't even know this was a thing until 2018. Never heard of it. I had a coworker say, hey, have you heard of Mandela Effect? I'm like, the what? So that's where I first heard it, ever. Not on the internet. Anything.
I heard of it back in, it was back when I started working at the casino. It was about 2011, I believe, is when I first heard about it. Now, it was first coined in 2009. So
my question is how did we go, or how did you go from 2009 all the way to 2011 not hearing it ever?
I don't know.
How did I go from 1999 all the way to 2018, never hearing of it ever? Not even from you. You never mentioned it ever.
Well, so it was one of those things.
Derek never mentioned it.
That hearing about it was like, oh, cool. And then I never really thought about it again. Except for when I did. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, when I would hear about things, I'm like, no, that really happened. That happened. I know that happened. And that right there is the biggest one, Shazam. I specifically remember that happening.
So, thank you guys for joining us for another Fandom Minutes, and I hope you enjoyed that one. I thought that was very, very interesting, and we're glad to have Mike back here. We'll be sure to get that put away for you guys so that you don't have to worry being out there. And
fairy hunting.
Yeah.
It's not a job. It's an adventure.
Yeah. I'm glad I didn't have to go out and deal with that. I'm glad that you had to deal with all that.
But on a more serious note, hope you guys enjoyed that video. If you did, smash the like button, comment, subscribe. Let us know what you think.
Yeah.
And
don't forget, take a picture of what you think the Thinker does.
Do you think he was doing this? Do you think he's doing this? Do you think he's doing some weird little pose like this? What you think?
Maybe he's dabbing for you. Maybe you know a Thinker where he's like that.
Something you'll never see me do in a million years. Alright guys, and be sure to tune in next week. We'll have a whole new episode for you, ready to go.
Yep.
And hope you guys enjoy that one just as much as I hope you enjoyed this one.